Tonight I'm going to talk to you this 400 seconds that I have about the Internet of Things. It's connected to the CPDP conference that I'm attending, but I realize this is not a panel, so I'm going to keep it light and hope you can just sit back and enjoy what I'm going to tell about the Internet of Things. Well, first a little about me. I always wanted to put a selfie in a presentation, so I did. I work for Ethicas Research and Consulting in Barcelona, and we give ethical and legal advice on data-intensive technologies. And so, basically, my work is in privacy. And as a privacy advocate, I sometimes get frustrated. I read things in the news, I see technologies emerge, and I think, who comes up with this? Don't they see that it's an unacceptable infringement of privacy? So I thought, I need some kind of therapy to blow off steam. I need to actually laugh about it. So I found my own therapy, and I want to talk to you about it. I found it in the Internet of Things. Well, the Internet of Things, I'm not going to give a deep analysis of what it is, of what the dangers are, but basically, take a device, make sure it connects to the internet, and it's a smart device. It also has a lot of negative sides to it, because it's a vulnerable platform that's very susceptible for hacking, for example. But again, I'm not going to give a full analysis on the dangers of IoT. Now, I want to talk to you about the beautiful power that technology has to create behaviors, to change behaviors. But some technologies don't necessarily solve a very compelling problem. So I started to collecting useless IoT devices. Internet of Things you don't really need. If you're on Twitter, you might follow Internet of Shit. It's a very interesting account that does the same. I'm going to show you my 10 favorite IoT useless devices. I hope you're ready. Because number 10 is the smart egg tray. Yes. It comes with an app. And everywhere you go, you can check how many eggs you have left at home. Including when they go bad. That's something we really need. Yeah. Then is the smart candle. It's actually a regular candle with a regular flame. But instead of using a lighter, you use an app to turn it on. And the candle is, of course, 100 euros, so yeah, that's very useful. Oh, and then there's L'Oreal's newest invention, the smart hairbrush. When you brush your hair, you can actually analyze your frizziness of your hair, your split ends. And of course, L'Oreal is so kind to recommend you their own luxury products, of course. Oh, and the brush is $200 as well. The internet-connected Christmas ornament. It's a regular ornament. Instead, it's connected to the internet, so you can stream your photos or have a Christmas countdown, stream your Bible verses. They even have a plug-in that's called the Santa Tracker. That's very interesting in this regard. Okay, so far these have been the regular things that we found in our houses. But it can get a little more personal. Yeah, I'm a little nervous as well to talk about this. But we're going to talk about personal data in regards to Internet of Things. The tweeting diaper. This is a clip-on humidity sensor that sends a tweet to the parents whenever their child is in need of a diaper change. A tweet. Yeah, I'm speechless. Oh, and this one is very interesting. It's a wearable that detects your heartbeat. And when you don't have a heartbeat, it sends a goodbye tweet to all your followers. It's a wearable especially for this. And this is also the logical consequence of the Internet of Things. You can now measure your temperature. Oh, the screen is like... You can measure your temperature, yes, correctly, and through an app. And actually, the App Store wants access to your contacts, your media files, and your microphone. Oh, and of course, when there's Internet of Things, somebody invents a smart vibrator. This was actually recently in the news because it was a suit for privacy infringement. Because the owners, the company, collected without consent information about frequency of use and even temperature. Okay, if you thought this was, I said vibrator and I said shit and I said rectal. Whew. But it gets worse. Worse? Well, the coming to are my favorite. They combine everything of the Internet of Things that like really startled me. So grab your popcorn, because this is the Kissinger. It's actually a nice device that you can buy. It has a rubber patch with sensors, and it senses your lip pressure, so you can transfer your kiss through the internet to your beloved one at a distance. Well, I have a long distance relationship, but I wouldn't see myself kissing my phone. Then there's the smart toaster. Yeah, this is like the cliche thing to connect to the internet. And you can send with an app a personalized message to your toast. Look how happy this guy is to be reminded of to pay his bills. Okay, but there's also, of course, a really serious matter of what I just talked about, because us philosophers, us data protection lawyers, we need to be aware of what's happening, how to what extent Internet of Things is actually affecting our privacy. We just laughed about these things, and I'm glad you did, because I really laughed about it too. But it's a serious issue. But tonight, I hope you enjoyed my therapy. Follow me on Twitter, but also don't forget to follow the Internet of Shit on Twitter, because it's really funny. Thank you for your attention.